Hi, I'm Casey. I'm a professor in an information science department, and I love giving advice to graduate students. I recently asked what kinds of topics might be useful, and one that rose to the top was how to make the most out of classes in grad school. Now, especially if you've seen some of my other videos, in particular, reasons to pursue a PhD, etc., you might have heard me say before that, particularly when you're a PhD student, classes aren't the most important thing, and that is still true. But they can still be really great, particularly in terms of learning the things that you need to know to do your research and even pushing forward your research directly. So with that in mind, a lot of the things that I'm talking about here are most applicable to PhD students. However, I think a lot of these tips would also be helpful if you're, for example, pursuing a master's degree. So first of all, what classes should you even take? Of course, keep in mind that you're going to have specific requirements of your program. Often this is some combination of things directly in your discipline and in your department and things outside. For example, when I was a master's student studying human-computer interaction, I took a lot of classes on things like usability and experimental design and some programming classes, but also I took a class on interactive fiction. You're not going gen ed like you do in an undergrad degree, but you're also not typically taking exactly only things that are directly in your discipline, because it's good to have some breadth too. Of course, this will vary from department to department. For example, in our PhD program, there are only 3 required classes that every single PhD student takes those exact 3 classes. Then we have some sort of competencies that you have to fulfill, a class that checks this box and this box. But a lot of these classes can be taken anywhere at the university. My PhD advisees, for example, have taken classes in education, in media studies, in computer science, even at the law school. But in general, the way to think about it is, what are the things that you need to learn? And sometimes these are domain-based things, and sometimes they're methods. I have to tell you, something that I regret from when I was a PhD student is I wish I had taken a class on information visualization. That's both a domain and a skill that is so useful. And I didn't take it in part because I thought it was going to be hard. That's not a good reason. Plus, you can always reach out to a faculty member to ask about the class. Do you think I have the requisite knowledge to be able to do what's in this class? Here are some things I'm hoping to get out of it. Would this be the case? And especially if you're a PhD student, a great question to ask is, will I be able to choose the project that I do in this class or the paper that I write in this class? Because one important thing for classes, especially if you're a PhD student, is always try to make the bulk of the work that you're doing in that class be directly related to your research. Maybe it's writing a paper. Maybe it's doing a project that could be directly related to your dissertation, or if not, a project that could turn into a publishable paper. I'm teaching a class right now in online communities. There are a couple of PhD students in this class, and one of them just proposed a project that is really related to what she wants to do for her dissertation work. It might not end up being like a chapter in her dissertation, the thing that she does for this one class, but it is going to be useful work that I think is going to guide the next project that she does. Similarly, I teach a tech ethics class, and several PhD students who have taken that class have started projects that turned into papers that they wrote for class that they then built out into papers that have now been published. Now, this isn't always possible, but when it is, it's really good. And as a professor, if I teach a class that has PhD students in it, I try to give them as much freedom as possible for whatever they're doing in that class so they can make it work for them. So honestly, that's probably my biggest piece of advice for a PhD student is, can you make this class work for your research? Or can this class result in a publishable paper? And this is also something that can be really good to talk to your advisor about. You should be talking to them about what classes you're choosing anyway. But even when you start taking the class, you might want to have a chat with them about the constraints of the project in the class and see if they can help you figure out something that would be useful for your research. And something else that is useful for your research is take advantage of the opportunity to do readings in classes. Treat it the same way as when you're doing readings to write a lit review for a paper. Take notes about the important points so you can remember them later. Keep them nicely organized in your citation manager. Remember, that's one of my first tips about being a PhD student is pick a citation manager, do it well. Because when it's 10 years later, you'll really wish that you had done that. It's also very possible that you'll be reading things in classes that might be part of your preliminary exams or qualifying exams. If you're thinking about a PhD and you don't know what that is, check out my video about the parts of a PhD. But it often involves a very long reading list. The ability to read things and apply them to the things that you care about is actually really important, and classes give you a great chance to practice that skill. Even if it doesn't seem like it's that relevant, there's probably some nugget of insight in it that might be useful for you someday. Classes also give you a great opportunity to connect with other students who are interested in the same kinds of things that you are. Take the opportunity to work with other graduate students when you can. Maybe make a study group. It'll help you make friends. It'll help you draw connections between your work and other students who are interested in similar things, even or maybe especially if they're in a different discipline. That can be so valuable. And I would actually really encourage you to use your classes to try to draw these cross-disciplinary connections if you can. And of course, classes also give you the opportunity to connect with faculty. Especially early in your PhD, you should be constantly on the lookout for committee members. Who are the faculty who are going to be able to help me push my dissertation forward? And in fact, that's something that you should be considering when choosing your classes. Who are the faculty that you want to get to know better? That can even be an entire reason to choose a class. And when you're in those classes, make a good impression. This means participating in class discussions, doing good work in terms of reflecting on readings or writing papers, etc., talking to professors in office hours. Often talking to a professor in your class about how you see your research as related to that class can actually be really nice. And I love having these conversations with students. It's so exciting. In fact, one of the very first PhD students who took my technology ethics class ended up writing such a great paper that I asked her if she wanted to join my research lab. We ended up writing two papers together, and I was on her committee, and it was initially just because she took my class. And also remember that the writing that you do in this class, even if you're not fortunate enough to have it directly relate to your research or turn into something publishable, you're still getting really important practice in academic writing. And so I would encourage you to take that opportunity to get feedback from a professor. And if you write something in the class that doesn't seem like a full paper yet, etc., but you had a really interesting idea, why don't you put it in a blog post? Tweet about it. Or turn it into a nugget of something that you can explore later. Sometimes the papers that you write in classes can turn into a segment of a lit review and something that you do as part of your research. And notice that none of the things I'm talking about here are advice for getting a good grade in a class. Honestly, by the time you're a PhD student, especially, that's just not the most important goal anymore. And honestly, even for master's students, like, sure, you want to have a high GPA, it might help you get a job, but really, you should be thinking of classes as an opportunity. Once you're done with school, you often don't have this luxury anymore to just learn things, to just have time that is completely devoted to learning things. I wish I had that time. I have to make the time to like read papers, right? Oh my gosh, if someone told me I had to spend 5 hours a week working on learning. Such a nice idea. So I'm sure you could find lots of other advice about how to succeed in grad school classes. But what I want you to do is make the most out of them. Make them work for you. Learn things, practice things, make connections, and even push forward your research or make brand new research. And if you are working on your graduate school classes now, I hope this was a useful way to think about it. And I hope that your next class is everything that you could hope it would be. I'm Casey. Thanks for watching.